The US Navy has acknowledged the need for developing the next generation anti-ship missile. Anti-ship missiles have been the area of concern for some time now. The US Harpoon missile is comprehensively outgunned by Indo-Russian Brahmos. India is an ally, but Russia is a rival, and has deployed Brahmos to counter the US Navy. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the problems with Harpoon and examines if Lockheed Martin's LRASM, long-range anti-ship missile, is the apt answer to Brahmos. Let's get started.
Number 5.
Harpoon Block II ER, extended range, is an over-the-horizon anti-ship missile manufactured by Boeing. It's a major upgrade of Harpoon Block I missile and is currently the main ASM, anti-ship missile, in the USA's armor. Harpoon II ER has improved turbojet engine and electronic fuel controls, giving it much greater range when compared to its predecessor. It uses solid propellant booster for surface and submarine launch. It has a capability to reach targets at a maximum distance of 124 kilometers. Harpoon is powered by traditional solid propellant engine. Harpoon has a speed of 0.7 Mach, which means it has high subsonic speed, but it's not supersonic. The design is of older generation and coupled with low speed, it's vulnerable to air defenses.
Number 4.
Brahmos is a one-of-a-kind anti-ship missile, which has supersonic speed. It travels at 2.7 to 3.0 Mach. It is a two-stage missile with a solid propellant booster engine as its first stage, which brings it to supersonic speed and then gets separated. The liquid ramjet, or the second stage, then takes the missile closer to 3 Mach speed in cruise phase. Currently, Brahmos has a range of 295 kilometers. Russia is a signatory of MTCR, Missile Technology Control Regime, and India was not. According to the MTCR guidelines, Russia could not help or jointly develop a missile with a non-MTCR nation, whose range is more than 300 kilometers. This is why Brahmos' range had to be limited below 300 kilometers. Recently, India has entered into the Missile Technology Control Regime, which effectively gives it a free hand in developing or importing long-range missiles from other countries. India and Russia has decided to double the range of Brahmos missile from the existing 295 kilometers to 600 kilometers. Russian President Putin made a mention of this last year when speaking to journalists from Russia. He said, "We have agreed to improve the Brahmos missile, which will be land, air, and sea launched. We will also work to increase its range." In both range and speed, Brahmos is far ahead of Harpoon II ER and pose one of the strongest challenges to the US naval fleet. Russia is already working on hypersonic version of Brahmos, and it's also developing Zircon missile, which reached speed of Mach 8 in recent tests. Both of these employ scramjet engines.
Number 3.
The AGM-158C LRASM is a stealthy anti-ship cruise missile under development for the United States Navy. The joint DARPA and U.S. Navy LRASM program was initiated in 2009 to develop a new generation of anti-ship weapons, offering longer ranges and better odds against improving air defense systems. Rob McHenry, a program manager in the Tactical Technology Office at DARPA, explained it this way to Aviation Week. "We want U.S. Navy cruisers and destroyers to be able to stand off from outside of potential adversaries' direct counterfire range, and be able to safely engage and destroy high-value targets they may be engaging against from extended range, well beyond potential adversary ranges that we may have to face. Once the missile flies that far, it has a requirement to be able to independently detect and validate the target that it was shot at. Finding that target, the missile will have to be able to penetrate the air defense, and finally, once it gets to that target, it has to have a lethal capability to make a difference once it gets there."
Number 2.
The US military is also expecting an environment where enemies try to jam or destroy the GPS systems, compounding its difficulties in targeting opponents. Those considerations underline the importance of autonomous targeting. Hence, beyond its anti-jamming digital GPS, LRASM will also rely on a two-way data link, a radar sensor that can detect ships, and a day-night camera for positive identification and final targeting. The LRASM is 168 inches long and 2,500 pounds. It's estimated that the LRASM has a range of 300 nautical miles, that's 560 kilometers or 350 miles. LRASM is armed with a proven 1,000-pound penetrator and blast fragmentation warhead.
Number 1.
LRASM is expected to enter service in 2018. It will be a major leap over Harpoon 2 ER. Though it will have extremely advanced automated targeting system, it will still be a subsonic missile. By the time of its deployment, Russia will be in position to field BrahMos 2 as well as Zircon, both of which will be hypersonic missiles. As per the above details, it can be concluded that US will still be lagging in the anti-ship missile category when compared to Russia. Neither Russia nor China, the most powerful US rivals, have the budget to match the US defense spending. Total US military expenditures of $611 billion is over one-third of the world military expenditure. This is nearly three times the level of China's spending and nine times the spending of Russia. Hence, both Russia and China have searched for asymmetric weapons that can defeat American aircraft carrier and destroyers that project power beyond the American shores. Hypersonic anti-ship missiles are part of this effort and are here to stay as a quantum leap in destructive military firepower. This is one area where the US needs to pull up its socks.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. Kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.